my time in National Service, I started by tutoring my friends, siblings, younger sister, and then I was also helping my friend when I was still schooling.
Mm.
So that 10 years of experience, I thought that I want to be, I always tell myself that I want to be a teacher.
Mm.
But then I got a place in NTU for engineering, and consulting my teachers, my past teachers, they advised on not going to straight into NIE, going to get my degree first and then going to NIE afterwards.
Mm.
So after working for about 2.5 years,
mm.
I think that was the end. I call it quit. Not because I hated the job, I love the job, but I did not want to be an employee all the way.
Mm-hmm.
I was exposed to business and entrepreneurship when I was in NTU.
Okay.
A few of my friends started something, did something. So it further propels me to, you know, follow this calling of mine,
mm-hmm.
Which is to teach and give back, at least give back to the community.
Okay, so what makes your tuition center different from other tuition centers?
What makes my center different?
Mm. How do you inspire your students? And what are you basically, okay, your goal is to improve their grades,
yeah.
Yeah. But what inspires you to do that? You know, why the drive to do that?
Okay. First, okay, not the first reason, but one of the reasons I can say is for the past 10 years, the according to our statistics, national statistics,
mm-hmm.
Our grades in math and science haven't been improving.
You're talking about the Malay community.
Malay community, okay. We haven't been improving for the past 10 years. So, I came from a background where I failed my A levels.
Mm-hmm.
I had to repeat junior college. And that was one of the most embarrassing moments in my life.
Okay.
I was the school rugby captain. Then when we got our results, I was the only one in the team that did not make it through.
Okay.
So that was bad.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, but immediately I went to meet my teacher in charge, my rugby teacher in charge, and asked him, "So Mr. Sia, what am I going to do? What is going to happen to me?" He said, "Okay, we meet principal and see if we can repeat."
Mm-hmm.
So he immediately gave his green lights,
mm-hmm.
and I resumed JC in after the March holidays for that time.
Okay.
So
and that I was your first year?
That was the second time taking my levels.
Mm-hmm.
So that year I told myself that I'm there's no way I'm gonna get another E for my maths. Because all along I've got an A or A star for my maths, and I know I can do it.
Okay.
So about 7-8 months, I just work my way to get back my A for maths, and I did it.
Mm-hmm.
So during that 7-8 months, I realized one of the most significant or something that I did differently that caused me to get my A or and understand better is that I was teaching back my friends after I understood what I learned. So that was one of the models that I used for my class. Once I explain the concepts to the students, I get them to digest first, do a few practice, and just ask them to, you know, in their own words, explain the concept back to me.
Mm-hmm.
Explain back what they understood, why is it this way, why is it not that way, you know, at least they know what they're doing. So that's one of the things that I employ in my class.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, okay, apart from that, what other techniques do you use to actually make the students understand the concepts better?
What other techniques?
Mm-hmm.
For some chapters, mm-hmm. I use visual, I use physical things to explain to them.
Mm-hmm.
Especially on the subject of algebra is one,
mm-hmm.
and also trigonometry and circles. It is and also the 3D shapes.
Mm.
It is because that topics requires a lot of visualization.
Okay.
So sometimes just from a 2D dimension, drawing,
mm.
they cannot really see what is happening.
Okay.
So I use things, practical things like from the tables, our pencil case, our handphones, water bottles and everything to explain to them or let them see from another perspective how is it like this, you know. And after understanding that, we translate that concept on a paper again by drawing triangles, by drawing a simpler shape. So from there they know what is basically happening. Yeah.